The mystery of how a COVID cluster spread through a quarantine hotel is deepening tonight. Authorities learning more, but now grappling with more questions than answers, including whether the whole system needs a radical overhaul.
The Grand Chancellor, effectively a shell of a hotel. All 129 guests and staff evacuated as four new cases in quarantine were found, two from the US, two from South Africa.
None of them related to the Grand Chancellor outbreak.
220 staff have been contacted and are being tested, along with 75% of the 147 former guests and over 400 contacts of the infected cleaner.
I have very little concern that spread in the community.
How the cluster broke out, why six people in the hotel were infected with a UK strain, is under intense police and health investigation.
The main focus for the investigation is everything to do with the Grand Chancellor, its environment, how it operates, the processes that people used, what occurred.
There's a little clarity around the cleaner who contracted COVID-19 from the UK male who checked in on December 30 and went to hospital on January 3.
The cleaner was only there on the 2nd, right, and the man was still in the room on the 2nd, so the cleaner did not go into that room on the 2nd. There is nothing that I have found that says that the cleaner did anything wrong. This is a virus, a very, very contagious virus.
The race is now on to find safer quarantine alternatives, with isolated mine camps the favoured choice. The Premier says camps like the Northern Territory's Howard Springs are the most sensible, rational option.
Some of these mining camps are 4-star. They are of a very good quality, high standard. There's the capacity for all of the staff and the cleaners and everyone to also be based on those sites as well.
She'll raise it at tomorrow week's National Cabinet meeting. Lane Calcutt, 9 News.